Hello and welcome to The Life of Larry, former Vault 76 dweller. And we are about 2 weeks out of the vault. And as you can see from my snazzy golf outfit, I was very eager to get out of that vault suit. Right here, I'm at my little dwelling. I'm not much of a carpenter, but I've managed to find me a nice little secluded spot in the mountains. Kind of not far from some things, but kind of out of the beaten path as well. Because I've noticed some very strange things about living in Vault 76 for one reason. I was a grandfather when I went into the vault. And my grandson was a member of the military who was also selected to live in a vault up in the Commonwealth if things ever went awry. So somehow I allegedly spent 25 years in a vault, but yet I came out younger than when I went in. Another strange thing about living in the vault is I don't really remember living in the vault. That's like this Pip-Boy thing. Okay, we're given this Pip-Boy just before we leave the vault. There's no instruction manual, no telling how to use it. If you look down at the bottom, it has a date on it. But for some reason, the date keeps resetting. So, is it working as the Vault Tech people intended? Is it bugged or broken? Or is something really afoot? But this is the first of hopefully many of my holotapes. Now, granted, I can't make a holotape. So, I have to find other holotapes. So, you can see I have found quite a few of them. So, as we're going along, I will just keep recording over the ones I've already listened to. And some of them, the memory is shorter than others, so some videos may be longer than other videos. But it's all in the nature of learning how to record with this Pip-Boy. And the other thing we have, the only two things I left the vault with, I didn't even have a weapon when I left the vault, is this little gadget right here, this little camp builder, that if you feed it blueprints, it will help you build stuff like this water purifier, which I am an electrical technician by trade. I don't know much about power plants, which if you look at this one over here, off in the distance, there is a power plant over there, and I have seen some people over there from time to time. I don't know much about powering it up, but one of these days I might want to go over there and check it out. But one thing about leaving the vault is there were a couple hundred of us in there, and apparently everybody just went kind of hillbilly crazy when they got out. Everybody just scattered to the winds. I even had two young chaps try to kill me one day. I was scrapping some weapons that I found, minding my own business, and out of nowhere, these two former vault dwellers just start trying to kill me. So naturally, what do? I just ran away. But I am currently in my current residence, I am right outside of the Wade Airport. None of these planes appear to be functional, but there is a good bit of scrap to be found around here. That's why I kind of been hanging out over here. But there's a couple of before we go inside my house and look around for a minute, there are a couple of things that I have found really strange. I'm going to try to come over here and see if I can get a glimpse of it. I don't think I can see it through the trees, but kind of right behind this tree, somewhere in this area, because I know that is a little to the east of it, I guess. But there's an old train depot over here, and there is a robot inside of it that will only buy things from you or sell things to you for bottle caps. Oh man, that looks like dinner right there. Ooh, a multi-headed possum. No, we're not eating that. That chicken looks pretty scrumptious, though. Missed him. Got him that time. You carry on now, little possum. Don't be messing with my chicken. I probably could have ran around here and looked like a fool and tried to catch that chicken. Ooh, there's another one. And that must be why I only ever get the thigh. Shooting a chicken with a 308's probably a little overkill. But I got a little hankering for some. What was that? I got a little hankering for some chicken noodle soup anyway, so we'll come back over here to the camp. But anyway, I finally figured out how to not just listen to holotapes. I figured out with this Pip Boy on how to record them. The strange economy of buying things with bottle caps. And there's just so many things that just don't make sense about leaving the vault. For one, I kind of thought the whole purpose of of getting selected for Vault 76 was to come out here and reclaim society. And you would think that we would, kind of use the vault as a hub. But on the morning I woke up on Reclamation Day, I was the last person in the vault. Everybody had already left me. And as soon as I left, the vault door closed. And the vault is pretty much probably straight off in that direction. I'm basically due south of the vault. But I've just been going around scrounging some things, just like you saw with that three-headed possum or whatever it was. I've seen some strange things in 25 years. One of the craziest was a dragon. I literally saw a dragon. Now, I don't know exactly what they did to us in the vault. I don't recall ever even living in the vault. I don't know if it's a real memory, an implanted memory, or if this is some kind of virtual reality simulator with this Pip Boy clock continuously resetting itself for some reason. But in 2 weeks, with this fancy little camp simulator thing that I have. And that's something else. I just had a mission pop up on my Pip Boy that there is a supply drop right over here. Who's dropping the supply drops? We've been in a vault for 25 years. All right. I have not managed to find a work in radio anywhere in this place. But you can hear a little soft classical music because I found this old busted up jukebox, and let me tell you, it was a pain to get up here. But all it plays is classical music. All of them tapes in there, classical music. Hey, it's peaceful anyway. But this is my nice little, pretty much one room shack. It's pretty plain because, like I said, I'm not much of a construction guy. I got all the pretty much necessary little things I have, and Don't tell anyone, but I stash all my good stuff in the busted up milk machine, because who's going to look in a busted up milk machine? Who wants to drink 25-year-old milk? Now, if somebody could come up with a diet Nuka-Cola, well, no, I'd drink that hot any day of the week. But 25-year-old milk? Yeah, that's leaves a lot to be desired. But anyway, I'm going to try to keep making these holotapes. It's kind of the memory, implanted memory, whatever we were told in the simulator, I have no idea. We're supposed to be out here reclaiming society, but I'm telling you, I've seen some strange things. Not least of which is that dragon, but I've seen a headless beast kind of over here in this area, right on the other side of this hill. There's big green men that roam around this airport from time to time that my pit boy identifies as super mutants. I call them stupor mutants, but oddly enough, the stupor mutants are the only things that talk. Well, that's not true. The robots say pretty stupid things as well, the few that I've encountered that haven't tried to kill me. Now, there is a radio up here in this tower, so my goal is why I picked to live here is I used to be a radio operator. And if you could see, I already put my call sign up on my shack. And if we can ever manage to get a radio station going, we're going to call it WGSG Radio, because that's the way we roll here in the apocalypse. We're going to try to get some jams out there other than classical music. And hey, if we have to live this life in solitude, we're just going to make it happen. Now, there's this little redhead that comes by every now and then named Andalee. I don't remember meeting her in the vault either, but then again, the few strangers I've come across out here in the mountains, I don't remember seeing them in the vault either. But Andalee, she claims she's not much of a builder type. She just comes by, stashes a few things in the milk machine, has me repair some weapons or few items, cooks her up some grub every now and then she's gone just as quickly as she stopped by. But who knows, she might be around someday when I record one of my little holotapes. But until the next time, whenever that may be, this is Life with Larry, Holotape 1, signing off, and maybe next time, just maybe next time, we will actually go out and about and kind of see what we can scrounge up. But hey, if I'm going to end up being one of the last people on the planet, we're at least going to kind of record what we see and find. So if someday one of these other vaults happen to open up, maybe they will come across Life with Larry's holotapes, and maybe I can pass on some bit of information that will be useful to someone. And who knows, maybe the other vaults will never open. Maybe I was never in a vault either. I sure came out of one, but I don't ever remember going into it. But until next time, this is Larry. See you soon.